talk. So we now humbly and respectfully request Sayadaw to kindly give us Dharma talk, very deep, profound Dharma that can inspire us towards the realization of Nibbana.
If you want to attain Nibbana, what you should do? First, you should try to understand Four Noble Truths. Tathagatam Bhikkhave Ariya Sajjana Ananda Bodha Abhri Veda Yavamida Digamadana Sandhavida Sansarita Mamichiva Dhamma Gencha. In this way, when our Buddha is ready to go to Pranibbana, at the time last year, he wandered through Vaisali, around Vaisali. He taught many embodied dhammas. Among these many embodied dhammas, one dhamma is Kodigama Sauda. Kodigama Sauda means when he arrived at Kodigama village, other than he teach this Sauda. Chatona Bhikkhave Ariya Sajjana Ananda Bodha Abhri Veda Eva Mita Diga Madana Sandhavida Sansrita Mamichiva Dhamma Gencha. What is the meaning? Because of not penetrating the Four Noble Truths, you and me wandered through all this round of rebirth. When we wandered through all this round of rebirth, we do not know Four Noble Truths. We must try for realization of Four Noble Truths by direct knowledge, not hearsay. First, you should try learning knowledge. What is the noble truth of suffering, dukkha, sijja? What is the noble truth of the origin of suffering, dukkha, samudaya, sijja? What is the noble truth of cessation of suffering, dukkha, nirodha, riya, sijja? What is the noble truth of the practice leading to the cessation of suffering, Magga Sijja? These Four Noble Truths you must try to understand by your own direct knowledge. What is Dukkha Sijja? In Dhamma Jaga Bodhana Sutta, Buddha teaches Sankhitana Binshupadana Kanda Dukkha. In brief, five aggregates of clinging are called Dukkha Sijja. What are five aggregates of clinging? Rupa Badane Khanda, Vedanu Badane Khanda, Sinyu Badane Khanda, Sankharu Badane Khanda, Vinyanu Badane Khanda. All together there are five aggregates of clinging. What is Rupa Badane Khanda? In Khanda Vegas, there is one soda, Khanda soda. In that soda, Buddha had already explained Yangenchi, Rupa, Didanagata, Bishopana, Ijadawa, Vidawa, Olarigawa, Sukumawa, Hinawa, Banidawa, Yandure, Sandigewa, Sabha, Rupa, Sazon, Ubadaniya, Yahuchadi, Rupa, Badane, Khanda. In this way, Buddha had already explained past, present, and future Rupa. Indana Rupa, Israna Rupa. Hina, Imperia, and Subiria Rupa. Pa and Nia Rupa. All together, 11 types. These 11 types of Rupas are, if they are the object of Asava, and they are grasped by Kama, which is accumulated based on Tana Deji. This Kama grasp, this is my Raza in this way. Such type of 11 types of Rupa are called Rupa Badane Khanda. In the same way, 11 types of Rupa, Sinya Agon, Sinyu Badane Kanda, 11 types of Vedana Agon, Vedanu Badane Kanda, 11 types of Chidasikas, Hadda Divine Chirana, Agon, Sankaru Badane Kanda, 11 types of consciousness Agon, Vinyanu Badane Kanda. Altogether, there are five aggregates. Among five aggregates, past five aggregates, present five aggregates, future five aggregates, all are included. Internal and external, both internal and external, inferior and superior, far and near. What is far near? Far means a meditator's concentrated mind. Understands is very difficult for realization of these rupas and this far from his knowledge. This is called parupa, virana, sanya, sankhara, vijnana. Very easy to understand is called niya. This is virana, sanya, rupa, virana, sanya, sankhara, vijnana. This is very easy to do for realization of this Vedana Sanya Sankhara Vijnana are called Nila Niya. So if you all these 11 types of five aggregates are called Dukkha Saccha. According to Buddha's teaching, Rupa arise as a subatomic particle. In Bali they are called Kalabas. For realization of these Kalabas, how you should try to practice. These glabas are not rupa. This is the smallest unit of rupa. If you, again, you must analyze these glabas. In each glaba, there are at least eight types of materiality. An element water, element fire, element wind, all element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, all together, eight types. Sometimes there may be 10 types of rupa, sometimes there may be 11 types of rupa, sometimes there may be 12 types of rupa. These rupas are called pramata rupa. We are not seen to each other. This is also rupa. This is not pramata rupa. This is only pinyati. So you should try to understand Pramata rupa, pramata nama. How you should practice? In Sicca Sanyoga, Buddha had already explained Samadhi Bhikkhu Bhavita Samahito Bhikkhu Bhikkhu Yatha Buddha Bhajanadi. Bhikkhus develop concentration. A concentrated mind understand the Dhammas as they really are. What does he understand? Kencha Yatha Buddha Bhajanadi. He understands Idan Dukkha Yatha Buddha Bhajanadi, Yan Dukkha Samudiyodi Yatha Buddha Bhajanadi, Yan Dukkha Nirodhodi Yatha Buddha Bhajanadi, Yan Dukkha Nirodha Gami Nibri Vradi Yatha Buddha Bhajanadi, Yan Dukkha Nirodha Gami Nibri Vradi Yatha Buddha Bhajanadi. In this way, we should first try to develop concentration. Because concentrated mind produces the power of light. Under the light, if you can practice the four elements in meditation systematically, you can see these rupas clearly. If there is no light, it is not easy to see these rupas. So for realization of these rupas, first you should practice samatha. There are 40 samatha meditation subjects. Among 40, you can practice anyway, any jhana. Especially in many sutras, Buddha encouraged to develop up to fourth jhana. Depending on fourth jhana, if you practice four elements in meditation systematically, why we should practice four elements in meditation? Samatha meditation, there are 40 samatha meditation subjects. But when you are practicing vipassana, there are two meditation subjects, rupa gamadhana and arupa gamadhana. One of the practices in Rupa Kamathana, Buddha teaches only two ways. Tata Bhagava Rupa Kamathana Gachanjo, Sinkepa Manasikara Vasenava, Vitara Manasikara Vasenava, Chatutadu Vavatana Gachesi. Four elements in meditation Buddha teach in a brief way or in a wider way. This is Buddha's teaching. According to Buddha's teaching, if you want to practice, then you will understand this paramattha rupa, ultimate materiality. After realization of paramattha rupa, then you can go to for realization of paramattha nama. It is impossible. Without realization, without understanding paramattha rupa, if you practice nama gamathana, it is impossible to understand clearly. So, systematically, you must try to practice samatha vipassana. Then, if you practice systematically one day, you may realize nirvana. When your vipassana inside becomes mature, at the end of vipassana, then you there may arise mega jnana and phala jnana. This mega jnana and phala jnana will take nirvana as object, other than you may attain nirvana only. Okay? Okay. If you want to practice anabana, please pay attention on the nostril. Here, nostril. On that gate, you can wait and see in-breath and out-breath. Don't follow inside the nostril. Don't follow outside the nostril. Then you should, when practicing focusing the breath, you should not use your eye to see breath. Please focus mentally only. If you focus on the nostril, the breath object, you must be able to concentrate on breath object at least 10 or 20 minutes, etc. If you can concentrate at that, then you, again, you must practice to understand long breath and short breath. Long and short breath. When it is long, you should try to understand from the beginning to the end. When it is short, you should try to understand from the beginning to the end. Long and short means if you breathe slowly, it is called long breath. If you breathe quickly, it is called short breath. But additionally, you should not try to make the breath long or short. Please allow in a natural way. Natural way, you should wait and see here. From the beginning, here begins, here ends. Only one point. From beginning to the end, you should try to understand the breath and please concentrate on that long and short breath. When your concentration improves, if you can concentrate more than 1 hour, 2 hours, etc., at that time, naturally, the breath will become subtle. Subtle breath is better. When the breath becomes subtle, you should not try to make the breath more clear. Please subtle breath, long subtle breath, short subtle breath. Then you should try again to understand from the beginning to the long subtle breath, from the beginning to the end. In the same way, from the beginning to the end of short subtle breath, please concentrate on that subtle breath object. If you can concentrate more than 2 hours, 3 hours, etc., then naturally the breath will become nibbida. Nibbida is the cause of jhana concentration. Because of this nibbida, you can practice jhana, taking this nibbida as object. But at the beginning, usually the breath will become nibbida is gray smoky kala nibbida. The gray smoky kala nibbida must unify with breath. When the breath began nibbida, nibbida also began breath. Nibbida and breath are saying, other than you quickly do not move your attention to the nibbida. If you pay attention, you may die quickly. Listen, you may die or disappear. Don't pay attention, you may die very quickly. Just stay with breath. When concentration improves, then mind naturally, automatically stick to the nimitta object because nimitta and breath become one. At that time, when your mind stick to the nimitta, at that time you can pay attention to nimitta. At that time, nimitta will not disappear quickly. You may be able to maintain your concentration on that nimitta. When concentration improves, the gray smoky kala nimitta will become white cotton wool kala nimitta. Gray smoky kala nimitta is called brigama nimitta. White cotton wool kala nimitta is called ogaha nimitta. Again, you must concentrate on that white cotton wool kala nimitta. When your concentration improves further, white cotton wool kala nimitta will change into translucent and bright kala nimitta, like morning star. That's right, morning star kala nimitta is called paribhaga nimitta. That paribhaga nimitta is the object of jhana concentration. If you can concentrate on that paribhaga nimitta, then when your concentration improves, full absorption will arise. Your mind completely will sink inside the nimitta and stay there for a long time without moving. At that time, you can attain jhana. Whether this is actually jhana or not, if you want to know, you should pay attention inside your heart. Inside your heart, there is bhavanga mindo, like translucent kala. Translucent kala nimitta, bhavanga mindo was inside your heart. Then there you can see five jhana padas, udaga, vichara, vidi, sukha, egagra. Then you can design these five jhana padas one by one. If you can see one by one clearly, again you should try to design these five jhana padas to sit together. At that time, you can attain jhana, first jhana. This five jhana, you must practice five mantras. Whenever you want to design this jhana padas, you must be able to design this jhana padas. And for beginners, commentary suggests not to pay attention to jhana padas frequently. You must practice to enter into jhana repeatedly for a long time. This concentration is important, and if your concentration, jhana concentration is stable for more than 1 hour, etc., other than you can try five masrari. Five masrari, please practice under the guidance of your teacher. If five masrari is okay, you can go on to second jhana. Then second jhana also five masrari is okay, then you can go to third jhana. And that jhana also five masrari is okay, then you can go up to fourth jhana. Fourth jhana concentration will produce strong powerful light. With the assistance of that powerful light, if you practice four elements of meditation systematically, you can see your body is composed of subatomic particles. In Bali, they are called kalabas. Again, if you analyze those kalabas, you will see paramattha rupas in each kalaba. And then you can anasra rupa. After that, you can try to practice to anasra nama mentality. After designing nama and rupa, then you can go on to design the dependent origination. This is a samburiya sajja. After designing samburiya sajja, then you can practice dukkha sajja and samburiya sajja dhammas are called sankhara dhammas. These sankhara dhammas you should contemplate as anicca, dukkha, and another systematically. Then you may attain nirvana if you have enough parami. Any question?
Anyone has any question? Maybe Saido can I, Saido say if we have enough parami. So how do we know whether we have enough parami? And
if you practice, you may understand. If you have enough parami, you can practice easily. But if you have your parami is very weak, you cannot practice easily. There may be some difficulties. Concentration also slowly might go away from the object. Another way is you should try, if you had already practiced anabana up to fourth jhana, other than with the assistance of fourth jhana, you can discern 32 parts of body. After discerning 32 parts of body, you can practice kasinas, kala kasinas, nila kasina, beda kasina, loida kasina, odada kasina, pokala kasinas. If you had to practice pokala kasinas, then you can practice other kasinas, patri kasina, abo kasina, dejo kasina, wayo kasina. Eight kasinas, if you had to practice barali up to eight times of jhara, then you can try to practice 40 ways again. Depending on 40 ways, if you practice open yuasa, nosity, abhinyana, psychic power, divine and psychic power, other than you may anasra barami, if you pay attention to the namakuba, bhagava, past lives, whether you have barami or not, you may anasra there.
Any questions? Shadow, there are many different types of meditation. How do we know which type of meditation or meditation object is suitable for us?
This is the domain of Buddha. I do not understand this. This is Buddha only can understand. Even Benariva Sariputta also do not understand. This is Asayanusya Jnana and Indriya Prabriyadi Jnana. These two jnanas, two subjects are the domain of Buddha, not our area.
During last retreat, right, one Pandit teach us to focus on the breath, but don't stop at the nostril, but follow it out. So should
maybe
we just focus?
Attainment of jhana is not easy.
So we just should focus on the nostril here.
That's maybe nostril inside the yomi, not outside. Outside is the problem, is inside this again. There are always four elements. You may see one element or two elements at that time. Four elements in meditation, anabana, will mix together. And then two meditation objects together simultaneously is not easy for attainment of jhana.
Thank you.
My mom is terminally ill, and now she is in her last moment already. So how can she prepare to die peacefully?
Maybe this is maybe before death is coming, they must prepare one meditation subject clearly to maintain their concentration. Near death moment is not easy. If they can practice anabana, for example, near death moment also they must practice anabana. When sufferings are very strong, other than to maintain concentration is not easy. So before death is coming, we must prepare. Near death moment, not easy.
Shadow, how to practice meditation metta for beginner without jhana?
Usually, if you want to practice metta, in Karaniya Metta Sutta, these bhikkhus are passed. They take meditation subject under the guidance of our Buddha. Buddha teaches the Kasinga meditations. Depending on Kasinga meditation, they practice vipassana up to Uddiyavya Jnana states, the knowledge of rise and fall. But when devas disturbed to them, they came back to the Buddha again. And then Buddha teaches them metta meditation. Depending on Kasinga, if they practice metta very easy, and very easily they can attain metta jhana. For example, one Kasinga, for example, white Kasinga, taking Sakalanda as object, they can practice white Kasinga up to fourth jhana. Depending on this fourth jhana concentration, if they pay attention to one Dhiya Bhasa, who is same sex, then they can easily penetrate this Bhasa and they can contemplate Metta meditation. And that the Metta jhana is very easy. For beginners, you may have one Dhiya Bhasa, Dhiya Bhrata maybe. If you focus this dear brother and send metta, I will hold may this good bhasa be free from danger, be free from mental suffering, be free from physical suffering, etc. In this way, if you send metta to attain jhana, is you must try hard a little bit. But if you practice based on Kasinga jhana metta, it is very easy. Usually, if they had been practicing Kasinga meditation up to fourth jhana, usually we teach metta meditation.
Okay, Seattle, sometimes when I do the meditation, it looks like my mind went into the blank. I'm not sure whether it is in the Pavaka. Or is it, am I still in the awareness? Because I still have awareness, but I'm not sure whether, am I suddenly went into the pavaka or no? How do I know whether it went in the pavaka?
What is your meditation subject?
Anapana, just anapana, still.
How do you feel, Buddha?
I'm not sure about this. Can we know whether we are in the pavaka or not? If we want to do that.
Maybe you must try to understand your meditation of the anabana, the only anabana, except anabana, you shall not pay attention to any other object.
Okay.
Bhunga maitri is usually niya jhana, it is rice.
Okay.
Niya jhana moment means you pay attention to paribhaga nimitta, translucent and bright nimitta. And then while focusing this nimitta before attainment of jhana concentration, this bhunga maitri usually appear. And then easy to say this is bhunga or this is no meditation object, etc. But you cannot concentrate well. If you cannot concentrate well, it is not easy to say this is bhunga or no bhunga, etc.
Thank you, Andy.
Seattle, I practice Anapanasati. Got one time, I see the light attached with the breath. So in this situation, I don't know, should I look the light or just keep focusing on the, because it's become together. Like,
in Wisodhi Mega, it is mentioned, Pota, Pota, Kasi, Bana, Sadang, Tupeta, Wabhavan, Dasi, Wabhavan, Sambhijati. On the touching point, if you pay attention only, you can attain jhana. But if you pay attention outside, you cannot attain jhana. This is Visuddhimagga's explanation. You should not move your attention from the nostril to outside. Outside nimitta is usually not the object of your meditation.
Hello? Hello, Bandy? Hello? Yeah. Hello, Bandy. We do understand the dukkha tissa, we need to know 11 type of yupa. But in under the 11 type of yupa, right, you mentioned that isitta and brahita. How can we know the brahita yupa?
Maybe this is as a general only. If you when you are practicing the two parts of body, internally, if you can see, and externally also you see clearly. At that time, if you see, for example, head, skull of external person, that skull you should pay attention for elements in meditation. Systematically, you cannot see skull, you can see only just kalabas, subatomic particles. If you analyze those kalabas, then you can see paramattha rupa. You must practice systematically. Just pay attention, it is not easy. For elements in meditation, you must practice systematically. Other than only you can understand, as a general only external one. Now one by one, entity, his mind, her mind, etc. In this way, you cannot practice, you cannot discern by vipassana knowledge. Vipassana object also as a general only.
Dear Bao Saido, the Buddha once said that we have to treat our parents like how we would treat Buddha.
Did the Buddha once say that we have to treat our parents the same as how we treat the Buddha? Our parents and the Buddha should be treated the same way. Did the Buddha say that?
I do not know.
To be able to see the kalapa, do we have to attain the full jhana up to, or can we able to see the kalapa even if we attain the first jhana?
Maybe kalapas are not the object of jhana.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I see. Then?
And then maybe if you practice four elements of meditation systematically, you can see kalapas. This is not jhana meditation.
Oh, I see. So through the element, practice of the, four elements?
Four elements in meditation, if you practice systematically, one day, if you see your body as a translucent body, other than you enter translucent body, you must try again, do anasran, 12 characteristics. In other words, it is four elements. Please concentrate on that translucent body, four elements. If you get, when your concentration improve further, then such a powerful light will appear at that time. With the assistance of that light, you can see space element. And then when you see space element, then you can see your body is composed of subatomic particles. This is because of four elements of meditation concentration produce strong, powerful light. Because of this, is under the light, you can see clearly. This is not jhana.
First of all, thank you very much for your compassion for coming to Singapore again. In this translated English book by Lady Seador. I think it mentioned, if I understood Lady Seador correctly, that the seeds of the seeds of sila and concentration are actually available even if there is no Buddha's dispensation. Whereas the seeds of panya is only available during Buddha's dispensation. So I think the book actually says that, you know, we should try to, practice or the seeds of panya, since it is only available during the Buddha's dispensation. So could Seador please, comment on that?
Maybe sila is outside Buddha's dispensation. In ancient times, there are our Bodhisattva Sarabhanga. He can teach samatha and abhinya psychic powers, but he cannot teach vipassana. At that time, if he can teach vipassana systematically, his disciples can become Sotapanna, Sakadagami, etc. Because he cannot teach. This is the vipassana is inside Buddha's dispensation, not outside Buddha's dispensation.
สรสรสรสิบยันตี้ดอเตียนน่ะแหละเท่ามาพ่อๆเนี่ยตะจีเลบ้าเตียတော့งาจ้าရပါတယ်ဗျာตะจีเลบ้าဟုတ်ပထဝီတေဇောအဘောဝါယောတခုချင်းစီကိုပြန့်နှံ့ပြီးတော့တည်စီရမယ်ဆိုတော့ဘယ်လိုမှတ်ပြီးတော့ဘယ်လိုတည်စီရမှာဖြစ်အဲ့ဒါကတော့မင်းလက်တွေ့ကျင့်မှတ်ပြီးမှာပဲ
မင်းလက်တွေ့မကျင့်ဘူးဆိုလို့ရှိရင်သိဖို့အတိတ်တော်မှာပဲဟုတ်ပါဘူးဥပမာပထဝီကညဇောပြောဟောတာကမာကျန်လေးပြောချောဖို့ဆိုပြီးတော့သဘောတရားချောဖို့ဓမ္မငင်းလေးပါဠိတော်မှာဟောတာဒီမာကျန်လေးကိုမာတဲ့သဘောကမင်းကိုသွားနှစ်ခုထိလိုက်မာနေတယ်မာတဲ့သဘောသိတာအဲ့ဒီလိုမာနေတဲ့သဘောဒီဘောလုံးရှိတယ်ဆိုတော့ကိုမင်းသိအောင်ရှုပါအဲ့ဒီတော့မာတဲ့သဘောကိုသိပြီဆိုတော့ကျန်းတဲ့သဘော ကျန်းတဲ့သဘောကအဲအပေါ်အံသွားလေးကိုရှာလေးနဲ့ပုတ်ကြည့်ကျန်းနေတယ်တွေ့နေတယ်အဲဒီကျန်းတဲ့သဘောကိုလည်းသိအောင်ဒီဘောလုံးမြင်အောင်ရှုပါလေးတဲ့သဘောဆိုတော့ကဒီကဖိလိုက်ရင်လေးနေတာအဲလေးတဲ့သဘောနဲ့ဒီဘောလုံးကလေးတဲ့သဘောမြင်အောင်ရှုပါမာကျန်းလေးပြောချောပေါ့ပြောတဲ့သဘောအတွင်းနှုတ်ကန်းသားကိုမရှာလေးနဲ့ထိချပြောင်းရှော့ထားရင်ပြောင်းပြောတဲ့သဘောကိုဒီဘောလုံးမြင်အောင်လိုက်ပြီးရှုပါ
ပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပါပ
စီကံလေးရှိတယ်။မှန
်ပါဗျာ
။စီကံကတော့ဒီမကြီးမှာတမာတိကအားကောင်းရင်တော့ရတယ်။ဒါကတစ်ချက်။နောက်တစ်ခုကယုတ်ကမထံကိုရှုထားပြီးဖြစ်ရမယ်။ဒါသူစီကံမဲ့တမတ်ချက်ပဲ။အဲ့တမာတိကလည်းမရှိဘူး။ယုတ်ကမထံလည်းမရှုရသေးဘူး။အဲ့ဒါစိတ်သွားရှုရင်အဲ့ဒီစိတ်မှာစိတ်စီလေးဘယ်နှလုံးရှိတယ်။ဒီစိတ်ကပဲဝိသိစဉ်အပြင်ဖြစ်သွားတယ်ဆိုရင်နားလည်ဖို့မလိုတော့ဘူး။ ဒီကဝိသိဇဉ်အပြင်ဘယ်လိုဖြစ်သွားတယ်အဲ့မှာစိတ်တခဏတခုတခုမှာစိတ်စရတဲ့ကဘယ်နှလုံးရှိတယ်ဆိုတာသိရင်တော့ရှုလို့ရပါတယ်စိတ်တခဏတခုတခုမှာစိတ်စရတဲ့ကဘယ်နှလုံးရှိတယ်ဆိုတာလည်းမသိဘူးအဲ့ဒီလိုမသိဘဲနဲ့မသိတာလေးတပုံကြီးခံပြီးရှောက်ပြီးစိတ်ကိုရှုတယ်ဆိုတော့လုံးတယ်ဘာမှမရပါဘူးဘာမှမဖြစ်နိုင်ဘူးသူစည်းကမ်းကပမာတိပထမရှိရမယ်သီလပထမဆုံးဖြူစင်ရမယ်ဖြူစင်းတဲ့သီလအကြီးဆုံးတော့မြေပေါ်မှာရည်တည်ပြီးတော့ဓမ္မာတိထူထောင်ရမယ်။ဓမ္မာတိစကားအောင်မြင်သွားခဲ့ရင်အဲဒီဓကမထံကိုစနေရရှုပြီးတော့ယုတ်တရားတွေကို ద్వార 6ပါးပေါ့မျက်စိနားနာလျာကိုနှလုံးဆိုတဲ့ ద్వార 6ပါးမှာရှိတဲ့ယုတ်တွေကိုစနေရသိသိရတယ်။ပြီးပြီးသိသိပြီးတဲ့အချိန်ကကျတော့မှအဲဒီ52ခုဓာတ်မှာရှိတဲ့ယုတ်တွေကိုပါဆက်လက်သိသိရတယ်။သိသိလို့အောင်မြင်ပြီးအဲဒီယုတ်တွေကိုအလုံးရှုလို့ရပြီဆိုတော့မှနံဂမထံပြောင်းရှုရအဲ့ဒီလိုနံဂမထံပြောင်းရှုတဲ့စနစ်ကတော့ဒါစာမလာတဲ့စနစ်ပေါ့အဲ့ဒီယုတ်ကိုမသိသေးဘဲနဲ့နံသောရှုလို့ရှင်ဘာမှမသိပါဘူးညာသောဘာမှမသိဘူးဆိုတော့အဲ့ဒီစိတ်မှာစိတ်စိတ်တွေဘယ်နှလုံးရှိတယ်မမြင်ဘူးရေကုန်ရအဖြစ်ဇောရီမှာဆိုရင်စိတ်စိတ်တွေက34 35စသည်ဖြင့်ရှိတယ်အဲ့ဒီစိတ်စိတ်တွေ34လုံးဆိုတော့ဘာလဲမသိဘူးအဲ့ဒီလိုဆိုရင်နံဂမထံရှုလဲရှုတယ်လို့မခေါ်နိုင်ပါဘူး။သူကနံဂမထံကစနစ်တကျသိအောင်ရှုရမယ်လုပ်ငန်းခွင်ဖြစ်ပါတယ
်။ကျေးဇူးကြီးမားပါတယ်ဗျာ။ကျေးဇူးပါ။ဒါသူစာဒု
Any other questions?
Good evening, sir. When I meditate, right, sometimes I meditate and then after that I will lost and then come back again. So how to overcome this problem?
Continuous practice will be necessary. Your mindfulness is very weak because of this reason. Continuous practice is when walking, when sitting, when standing, when lying down, in every bodily posture, you must focus on your meditation object.This is necessary. Sati must be, mindfulness sati must be strong. When mindfulness becomes very strong, you will be able to maintain your concentration on your meditation object.
Sadhu,
sadhu, sadhu. Shinpia, the video of Nyapa Daija Lushin,တရားထိုင်တဲ့ခါကျတော့ဝင်လေထွက်လေပဲအာယုံပြုပါရရှင်ဗျာတပီတော့လမ်းနေပါလေရှောက်ရုံသွားတဲ့ခါကျတော့ဝင်လေထွက်လေကိုရှုပေးမဲ့ဝင်လေထွက်လေကခဏနေကြတော့မထင်ရှားတော့ပဲနဲ့တပီတော့ရဲ့လမ်းလျှောက်တဲ့ဖက်နောက်မှန်ကအရင်မာလာပြီးတော့နောက်စီကိုထိလာပါလေရှင်အဲ့တော့တပီတော့အာယုံဆိုင်ဖို့ဝင်လေထွက်လေကိုအာယုံဆိုင်ရမလားအဲ့ဒီနာနေတဲ့ဖက်နောက်နဲ့နောက်စီကိုအာယုံဆိုင်ရမလားဘဲကိုအာယုံ
မဆိုင်ရင်ဝင်လေထွက်လေပဲဆက်ရှုပါကိုဝင်လေထွက်လေဆိုတော့မထင်ရှားတာကကိုတတိအာနယ်လို့ပ
ါ
ဒီကိုရှုတာကဒီနှံသီးပြဆိုရင်ဒီနှံသီးပြဘုံလေးရှိတယ်ဒါအဲ့ဒီဘုံလေးမှာပဲစိတ်ကငြိမ်အောင်ကတ်တာအဲ့ဒီဘုံလေးကလည်းဘယ်မှမရှုနဲ့
တယ်မ
သူကတော့နာရာကျင်နာလေးပေါ်ခြင်းလဲပေါ်ပြီမကြည့်နဲ့
တယ်မ
ကြည့်လို့ရှင်အဲ့ဒီနာရာကျင်နာကဘာတွေစိတ်စရတွေဘယ်နှလုံးဖြစ်နေလဲဆိုတာကိုနားမလည်နာမလည်းဆိုတော့အလကားပဲဝေဒနာရှုရဆိုရင်ဝေဒနာရှုတာကယုတ်ကမထံကိုရှုထားပြီးဖြစ်ရမယ်။တယ
်မ
။ယုတ်တရားကိုရှုပြီးမှဒီဝိသိဇဉ်အတိုင်းစိတ်စိတ်တွေတွေဖြစ်သွားတာကိုရှုနိုင်မှဒီဝေဒနာကိုရှုလို့ရပါတယ
်။ဆိုဒါကြောင့်ဒါဆိုရင်အရှင်မြတ်ဘယ်အချိန်မှဖြစ်တပြီးတော့ဝင်နေထွက်လေကိုပဲအာယုံပြုပြီးမြင်ရမှာပေါ့။
တယ်မ
။ကျေးဇူးပါရှင်။
Any other questions? If not, then let us all say Sadhu three times to thank Sayadaw for the Dharma talk and the Q&A. Sadhu.